Hello everyone, today I will be discussing the topic ricochet. I will be discussing the definition, its effects and the factors affecting it. So first let's talk about what ricochet is. So ricochet can be defined as a phenomena that leads to deflection of a projectile from its trajectory or the line of motion after hitting a hard object. As you can see in this picture, a bullet was supposed to come this way and then go this way only. But what happened here is, there is a surface, an intermediate surface in between the bullet's target, due to which it couldn't complete its normal pathway and it bounced off. So we can see that here it is the incident angle and this is the ricochet angle, the new angle that is formed because of bouncing off the bullet. Here we can see the same thing, only difference is that the surface here is plain, smooth surface, whereas here we are having an irregular or a bouncy surface. Now whenever a bullet is fired, it has two options. Either it can penetrate inside the target or it can bounce off and continue moving in the change direction. So what happens in ricochet is that the bullet is unable to penetrate. Okay, so the penetration object here or penetration thing here doesn't happen and the bullet bounces off. Alright, so here this is just another picture of showing how a bullet was supposed to go in this direction, but it ricocheted off and it changed its path, it changed its direction, changed the angle. So there are five main effects of ricochet. First is change in the trajectory. Now this must be very clear by seeing this diagram that the bullet was supposed to go this way, but it went this way. So the direction of the trajectory of the bullet completely changed because of ricocheting. Next is energy lost. So again, coming back to this diagram, what happened here is when the bullet strike this surface, it initially tried to penetrate inside and continued and try to continue its normal path, but that didn't happen because it didn't have enough energy to enter inside, but yet it tried, so that led to somehow loss of energy. So this process also leads to loss of energy of the bullet. Next is it loses its gyroscopic stability. Now obviously whenever a particular object is going to hit something in between its way and when it continue another path, it's not going to have the same stability. It has bounced off, so it's going to be lesser stable than the original path. Next is range is decreased. Obviously if bullet was supposed to travel half a meter and if some in between some surface has come, because of that it has changed its direction, obviously it's not going to have the same range. The range is definitely going to be lesser than it was going to be in the original path. Last but not the least, it may carry material from the intermediate surface. So we know the Locard's principle of exchange, according to which whenever an object strikes a particular another object, it's going to exchange material from it. So when this bullet will strike off this target, it's going to take some material of this target onto its own surface and then bounce off. So these are the five main effects of ricochet. Next we are going to talk about factors that affects the ricochet. First is velocity. Now velocity can be high velocity or low velocity. So high velocity bullets have more chances of penetration and less chances of ricocheting off. Now this is so because in high velocity the speed is obviously more. So the energy is more, because we know the formula of kinetic energy, which is half mv square. So if the speed is more, that is v square, v is more, velocity is more, then the overall kinetic energy is going to be more, which leads to more chances of fracture or melting of the target that the bullet is going to strike. So if there is any fracture or melting of the target, then obviously the bullet is going to penetrate inside the target rather than bouncing off. Also, this energy may melt or disintegrate the bullet itself. Alright, so next factor affecting the ricochet is the target material. What is the density of the target material is also important. If the density of target material is less, then there are more chances that the bullet will be able to penetrate inside, because the density is less, and if the density is more, then there are more chances that the bullet will not be able to penetrate and it will bounce off and it will show ricochet. Next is angle. So the striking angle of the bullet also decides whether it's going to penetrate or bounce off. Now the angle can be perpendicular, or it can be parallel, or obtuse angle, or acute angle. So the more the parallel is the angle, like for example in this picture, if the bullet comes horizontally right from here, then there are more chances that whenever the bullet is going to just touch the surface, it is going to just bounce off like this quickly and not penetrate. But if we take the case, like if bullet is coming right from here like this, then there are more chances that the bullet will instantly enter inside the target and it will penetrate and it will not bounce off. So angle also decides whether the bullet will ricochet off or it will penetrate inside. Next comes the bullet material. Now the bullet itself can be made up of hard or soft material. So bullet density also affects the ricochet, as in if the bullet material is hard, then there are very increased chances that the bullet will just penetrate inside the target. But if it is made up of soft material, then there are chances that the bullet is going to ricochet off. Next comes the distance. If there is more distance, like if we take an example that two bullets are fired, one bullet is fired from a distance of 2 meters from a target and another bullet is fired from a distance of 1 meter from the target. So which one will be able to penetrate? The one that is more closer, obviously. So the lesser that the distance is between the target and the bullet, the more energy it's going to have, and hence more chances of penetration and less chances of ricochet. Now if we talk about the second bullet that was farther away from the target, then it's gonna waste its energy more, like due to travel, and hence there are more chances that it will bounce off and show ricochet. Last but not the least, the bullet shape. Bullet can be round or pointed. We can see here in the picture a bullet that is round has more tendency to ricochet off easily. So this bullet has more tendency to ricochet off, whereas this pointed one has more tendency to get inside the intermediate target and not ricochet. So these were all the factors that affect ricochet. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and comment if you have any queries. Thank you.